It is a collecting time right now. This one right here by my thumb, that's a double egg. It'll be a double yolk. You can see how much bigger it is than the other eggs. And today we had -2. I think it's supposed to be in the negatives tonight as well. One of the main questions I get, and I'll answer it while I'm looking for eggs, it's always like an Easter egg hunt, is how do your quail do in the wintertime in your natural quail enclosures? And, you know, I think because quail are wild and they're so adapted to living in the wild that they do great as long as they have areas that are wind-free. So this is quail house number 2. The bottom just has hardware screen on it, but nothing else. So it's all fresh air. But with the snow falling off the roof, it kind of creates a little barrier that you can see. So this quail house in here is a little bit cooler than the other one. But the roof has greenhouse panels on it, so there's no wind or anything coming from there. And then in quail house number 2, their nest area is completely wind free. And this is actually a cozier nesting area than quail house number 1. It's smaller, and it just seems to get just kind of more perfect light for more warmth. Anyway, that's how I feel. And then the vestibule area, this is completely open. This little, our brooder area, this is wind-free back here. And we've got about 3 months before we start hatching, so they just nest in there. And the vestibule, this is just the hardware cloth on here, the screen, but no panel. So this is all fresh air. Fresh air, I would never stop fresh air from my animals. Fresh air, I think, is super important. But this part right here is completely open, and so they get snow, rain, wind, everything right here. And then the greenhouse panels start right about here. So this is wind free, and but the same temperature as outside. We don't provide any supplement heat or anything like that. And quail house number 1 nesting area is back here. Oh, they're still laying eggs. I thought I already did my egg search, you guys. Look at you. Here we go. Let's see. Oh, that's a pretty one. I just think quail eggs are like art. I think I'll never get tired of them. They're so beautiful. These girls are laying so super strong. So the coldest we've had so far this winter, and it's been a fairly mild winter, we had -45 ambient temperature, -75 wind chill, but only for like 2 to 3 days. I think it was 3 days. And usually that's a couple of weeks. And so they did super good with that. And like I said, it's been like -2. And they're all super chill and fine as long as they have areas to get out of the wind, which this area is wind free and it is nesty and cozy. So but you can see they're all super active, they're all super happy. In the winter time we rake everything out about once a month, and on the super cold snaps that we get, like when it gets in, down into like -40s, we do put extra straw in this area. But they're, you know, this is their egg laying time. They lay in the evening. They're super chill. They're just walking around, eating, laying eggs. I put out extra warm water for them about 3 times a day when it's sub-zero temperatures. But it's, you know, they're super happy. They get to do their quail things and be outside and walk around, and they're not restricted. And I think we have super chill, happy quail. So. And they don't flip out, you know, when I walk in here. I will tell you, side note, they're very used to our dogs. They're very used to our family. If a stranger, and they know who their family is, if a stranger comes into our garden to help us with chores or something, they do get a little bit agitated. So they get familiar with their people. And then they know who to be careful of. Like they're they're very aware of their environment. So, okay, happy winter day. Have a good evening.